Welcome to Simulink for Chemies. Today we're going to show how Simulink can be a valuable tool for modeling all sorts of real-world processes. Suppose we have a pressurized system with two tanks in series. The gas flows into the first tank at a mass flow rate Wi. The pressures in each tank, P1 and P2, change with time, as do the outlet flow rates from each tank. The volume in each tank is constant. We're also given the transfer functions already in the Laplace domain, describing the relationship between the output and input variables. So our objective today is to plot P1 prime, P2 prime, and Wi prime for 80 minutes if the flow rate of gas, Wi, is instantaneously increased from 30 to 40 pounds per minute and then instantaneously decreased to 35 pounds per minute after 20 minutes. If we look at our equations that are given, we can see that pressure in the first tank is a function of inlet flow rate as well as pressure in the second tank. Simultaneously, the pressure in the second tank is a function of the pressure in the first tank. Let's go over to Simulink. The process blocks, mux, and scope are already on the screen. We have to figure out the relationship between these blocks in order to generate an accurate model of the system. At this point, because we have equations showing how all of our variables are related, we don't really need the diagram of the tanks anymore. We can think of the system in a more abstract way. So we can see in the second equation that P2 is equal to P1 times a transfer function. That means if we were to express it graphically, P1 would enter the transfer function block. We can double click on the arrows and label them. This is P1 prime. And it exits as P2 prime. So P1 enters the transfer function block, gets multiplied by 0.8 over 5s plus 1, and this creates the output P2 prime. However, we still don't know where this P1 prime arrow is coming from. It's just floating in space right now. We need to figure out how to create this using our other variables and transfer functions. According to the first equation, P1 prime is equal to one term minus another term. One signal is being subtracted from another signal. So if we go into math operations in the library browser, we can express this using a subtract block. Now the first term in the equation comes from Wi prime multiplied by a transfer function. Therefore, draw an arrow from the block's input to the Wi prime signal. And connect this to the positive port on the subtract block. The other comes from P2 multiplied by a different transfer function. Therefore, draw an arrow from the block's input to the P2 signal. The P2 signal is coming out right here. So you can just loop this around and connect it. And then connect the output to the subtract port, the negative port on the subtract block. So this is all well and good, but we still don't know what Wi prime is or where it comes from. We can read the problem statement again. There are two instantaneous changes in flow rate, which when used together form the initial flow rate Wi prime. Therefore, we can put two step functions on the board and an add block. One step is at time 0 and one step is at time equals 20 minutes. The initial increase in flow rate is from 30 to 40 pounds per minute. This is an increase of 10 pounds per minute. So if expressed in deviation variables, this step change would start at 0 pounds per minute and end at 10. Therefore, we double click on one of the blocks and make the first step at a step time of 0, 10 pounds per minute. Now this step stays in effect. So in order to make the flow rate decrease by 5 pounds per minute at the right time, we make the other step occur at a step time of 20 minutes, start at an initial value of 0, and end at a final value of negative 5. Then we connect the two blocks to the add. Run the simulation for 80 minutes. All right, first, let's check out the step change. Did it behave the way we expected? It did. It increases to 10 pounds per minute, and then at time equals 20 minutes, it decreases to 5 pounds per minute. An important thing to note here is the units of the x and y axes. The x-axis is time. The y-axis is pounds per minute for the flow rate, but it's PSIG for the tank pressures. As inlet flow rate increases, the pressure in both tanks increases. Both tank pressures have stable but oscillatory responses to the change in flow rate. The pressure in the first tank increases more and at a faster rate. And the pressure in the first tank also oscillates more when there is a flow rate change. But eventually, the pressures in both tanks converge to a final steady state value. If you want to learn more about using Simulink to solve process control problems, you can subscribe to the Lafayette CHBE YouTube channel.